or system or medium of. Okay? Yes. Divination does not lie.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you're a prophet.
I'm the last prophet.
That's right. Yes. So his real birth date is not known. Am I right?
Yeah, I'm, you know, unknown.
You're unknown.
Yeah.
So you chose a birth date. Which date did you choose?
Yeah, I chose February.
Mm-hmm. 6th of February, right?
Yeah,
7th. And why? 7th. There's a reason to that. I know about you. I know about you.
I chose February because February was when the prophet was born, you know. That's Bob Marley.
The late Nestor. Sir Nestor Bob Marley.
Nestor Marley. So, you know, we are connecting the Aquarian and the Sagittarian.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay, so, you know. After your parents separated, you lived in Lagos with your father, and he was a school principal who unfortunately died when you were only 10 years old.
When I was 15.
Oh, 15.
Yes.
Okay, so I got that wrong. I'm sorry, 15.
Yeah, yeah.
You then moved back to Benin City.
Yes.
To stay with your mama.
Mama, yeah.
And then you soon joined the choir in your local Aladura church. So you're an Aladura follower.
Yeah, I'm an Aladura prophet.
Are you still Aladura today?
Or forever.
Okay, yeah. So you joined the choir with your local Aladura church.
Yes.
And your cousin, Amos McCroy, Greg.
Yeah, Greg, yeah, Greg.
Right?
Yeah.
And then you learned how to play the trumpet and the guitar.
Exactly.
And you composed music for the choir.
Exactly.
All right. Mm. Okay, so I'm not doing badly.
You're doing well. You're doing well. Everything.
Okay, let's talk about the 80s, right?
Yeah.
You went by the stage name Rajesh Khanal.
Rajesh Khanal.
Why Rajesh Khanal? Who's Rajesh Khanal?
Rajesh Khanal is an Indian superstar. I was into Indian movies, into Indian sound.
Right.
Indian music sound, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Yeah. So you chose his name?
Yes.
Okay.
That's,
and you joined the group called Jastics?
Jastics, yeah.
Right, with McCroy Greg, your cousin?
Yeah, exactly.
And singer Black Rice?
Yeah, Black Rice.
All right. And they were best known as the in-house band on a music show on NTA Benin, right?
Called Jastics.
Right, Jastics.
Yeah,
music Panorama.
Music Panorama,
right.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you toured with fellow reggae group, the Mandatas.
Mandatas.
Huge back in the day.
Yes.
Huge.
Yes.
And they were also the upcoming session musicians for reggae singer Eddie Rasta.
Yeah.
Who would then change her name to Evie Edna Ogole.
Edna Raskimono.
Right. Right.
Yeah,
okay. So tell us about those days, Majek. Was it really better back then than now? Was life really sweeter back
then?
Yeah,
you know, nothing is forever. Nothing is stable, you know. Nobody is forever.
Mm.
It's by the grace of the Most High God that you live. So when you live, you don't complain. You see,
right.
I was a producer with Tawansi Records. So in the 80s, before I record with Tawansi, they sent out the real record. I was a producer, an arranger, music producer, I'm saying.
Right.
So, you know, the way I see things, I'm grateful that I'm still among the living.
Right.
You can see, about a few days ago, there was an earthquake in Northeast India.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? People are dying. If you go to, you check the news, you see people in Syria, and it's migration of the Europeans.
Yeah.
It's like European exodus.
Yeah.
The Europeans are into some serious tribulation.
Mm.
So we Africans must give thanks because we're going through that same trauma.
Right.
Into that tribulation. So I have no regret because I'm still among the living.
That's right.
So when you're among the living, you must give thanks.
Yeah, and there's always hope, right?
There's hope, yeah. There's hope. You know, so we're among the living, give thanks, yeah.
So how old were you when you realized that you had a talent? Or was it somebody that made you know, or did you know within yourself that you had a talent?
I would give that question to my mother. My mother knew me when I was young, my mom.
Right.
So that's why the same thing I'm applicable to other children.
Mm.
See, you don't play with the mother, the woman. The woman is the power of every children, the woman.
Mm.
But the father sometimes they are careless because of carelessness. I would say that. They are careless because you don't. My mother was the one that discovered that I'm going to be a musician.
Right.
I'm going to give my mother the credit because she bought me my first guitar.
Right.
She knew I was going to be a guitarist. You know what I'm saying? See, that's a woman because the woman is more visionistic, more visionary.
Right.
my mother is a princess.
So she could see it.
She could see it.
Yeah.
Yeah, because the woman, most time with the problem with the African fathers, they underestimate the woman.
Right.
Yeah, because they think woman is just for sex. No. It's not just sex alone. It's beyond sexual activity. The woman is the mother of nature.
Yeah.
So see what I'm saying? So my mother saw me when I was a kid. She was a princess from the Omanuba Palace. You know, she's a, you go down.
Right.
Yeah, she's a princess, you know, and she told my mother, you know what, the princess speak any word, everyone listens. So she told my uncle, and say, yo, my uncle is a doctor, and he used to go to London, England, you know what I'm saying? At that time, that was in the 70s.
Yeah.
He told my uncle, say, yo, man, the child like music, man, we go to England, buy me a guitar.
Right.
So, which means my mother knew that I was going to be a musician at that time. That's why the new video I'm doing, my new video is going to be called, it's a movie track.
Right.
It's just be done by a movie station, by Nollywood. It's called The Power of a Woman.
Right.
That's my first video coming out with. It's called The Power of a Woman. I say,
nice.
Don't underestimate the power of a woman.
Nice.
She can fool around like you do.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the woman, until the Africans respect the dignity of a woman, and the inspiration and the power of a woman, there will not be a future for the African people.
Ah.
African will always live in illusions. They are confused already because they disobey the woman. So why the white man's world is higher than the African world, they respect the woman power.
Right.
Like I say, my mother made me a superstar.
Right.
Then I wrote a song, Mother.
Yeah. Yeah, so, yeah, I was going to come to that. So you wrote a song.
For my mother, yeah, because my mother was the one that made me a superstar.
Right. So at this point in time, I'm going to play the song.
Exactly.
And we're going to take a little break. And don't go away because my Jack Fashak is still in the studio with me right here on Mellow Magic, coming to you from Classic FM 97.3, the station that plays every song you know. And in case you don't know who this is, my name is Elbina Yelka, and we're leaving. Now, this one goes out to all the mothers out there. Yeah. Do not touch that dial.